Aye.
Every 15 minutes, someone in the United States dies or is seriously injured. We have a lot of incidents. Today, I killed. I thought I was in control of the situation like every other situation I get into because of my doing myself personally. This situation is different though, and it cost the lives of four other human beings. This mistake cannot be undone, reversed, or forgotten. Life can change for the worse than the blink of an eye. Too fast for anyone to control. Choices are made every second of our lives. Today, I made a choice that I will regret forever. With that, I wrote a song about my life-changing mistake called Apologies. Fix the damage that was done. Pray to Lord, forgive me, God. Could you forgive your son? Face the consequences of my actions, nowhere to run. Lone survivor of this tragedy, why was I the one? Who'd have thought one decision could change things so drastically? Not thinking rationally could cause such a catastrophe. Hardest pain and agony, I feel for the victim's families. If I could take their place, I swear I would do it happily.
Today, heaven took
person and got a new angel. Since the accident, I've gotten messages of sorry for your loss. Sam, I didn't lose you today as a son. A father-son is always loved. A father-son is always thought of. And a father-son is always being taught. And a father-son is always being taken care of. I love being your father. Every moment that I've had, every moment that I've spent with you on earth has been the pride and joy of my life. It was very tough to tell your brothers, but you live through them. The way Jake dresses, I see you. The way Joe talks, most of the time, I see you. And then there is Ben, your Ben's idol. I see a mini Sam in him, a big heart, a great athlete, and love of shoes and clothes. I didn't lose you today as a son. I will continue to talk to you every day. I will continue to teach you every day. I will never stop loving you. You will now be my guiding light. Yes, I miss seeing you, feeding you, watching you play basketball. And to your teammates, Tim and Isaac, PT, Lily, Nikita, Adeoke, Gabe, Osajibo, Jordan, Toby, Dara, Pino, and your coaches, Rob, and Coach Walton. The Monopoly board is still untouched in the sunroom that you left yesterday. Please pray for us, Sam.
Finally, 24 and a half years old, words I never dreamed I'd hear. I'm sorry to tell you, your wife, Ava, did not make it. Your wife, Ava, is dead. You hear this expression every day in our world, which is wrong. Life happens one day at a time. No, it does not. Life happens one moment at a time. My life was not changed in one day. My life was changed in one moment. And every moment of the life of my life, we build habits, patterns, routines, and every good and bad thing in this world is because of a choice or a decision that somebody has made, unless it's a natural disaster. Somebody chose the outcome that would eventually come. Not allowing it to happen, son, is they're not allowing what happened to them to define who they are. You know what happens to most people when bad comes their way? If I mistreated you, I was rude, nasty, or even I dealt with the stupidity of prejudice and racism, you would have no control over me doing what I did. You see what I'm saying? You know how many times you let other people define us? You ain't defined by what other people say to you. That goes for a person in this room, but you know what happens? So watch this. You have a physical heart. Everyone in this room has what we want to see. Your physical heart sends blood and oxygen to every part of your body. And if your physical heart ain't working right, your rest of your body is going to suffer. That goes for me, you, and everybody else. But you know what you and I also have? We have an emotional heart. And when our emotional heart ain't working right, the rest of our lives are affected by it. You know what our broken hearts tell us? You, me, and everybody in this room have had one in common. We've all had a heartbroken life. You know the number one outcome of a broken heart? Is I'm not good enough. I don't measure up. I'm not love. The fear of rejection. So you know why people make the choices they do? Because they don't want to be rejected. They want to feel valued and loved for the moment. You know, when you have a headache, 99% of every headache you have has nothing to do with your head. It has to do with another part of your body. You know what we all do? We anesthetize the pain of our head. Behavior has literally nothing to do other than more than the attitude and the condition of a person's heart. If my heart is broken, I'm going to operate out of a broken heart. If my heart is rejected, I'm operating out of a rejected hurt heart. I have to forgive a drunk driver who is doubly legally drunk. Forgiveness doesn't condone wrong. It says to me, I want to ask everybody in this room. Has anybody ever seen in their life a marriage, a family, a relationship, or a career become better because of unforgiveness? Absolutely not. Yet, you know what we do? There's nothing good that comes out of unforgiveness, but we still practice it. I can promise you, the man who drove drunk had been hurt in his life. He never dealt with his pain, and alcohol abuse became his temporary solution. And then guess what he did? Sir, if he ain't drunk in the first place, he ain't driving drunk. He's driving drunk because he's drunk in the first place. Why is he drunk in the first place? You know why? I got to anesthetize the pain. I forgave the man never to condone his wrong to set me free.
Okay, our today has been intense and full of emotion as we've witnessed the simulated collision involving nearby high school students. We have seen that when someone makes the choice to drink and then drive, the fatal traffic incident